infections that you can get by having sex with someone who has an infection. Chronic is long-lasting, and the presence of a chronic STD may have varying effects on the individual. And a condom is very beneficial in preventing STDs, but not all the time are they preventing. You can still get infections from using one, because they're not 100% safe, as she said in the video. Abstinence is the choice to not have sex, and monogamy is marriage with one person at a time.
So, depending on the STD, health problems could be serious. The risk is so high for teens because once they're sexually active, they won't know that they have STDs unless they're tested. And most of the common STDs are bacterial, which have little to no symptoms at all. So STDs like chlamydia or gonorrhea may not have symptoms, so teens won't even know that they have the STD.
Okay, some local statistics. In 2016, the number of STDs in Minnesota rose to an all-time high, and it was largely driven by a sharp increase in chlamydia cases among young adults and teens.
So some statistics nationally. Alaska is the highest ranking for STDs. They rank first in the nation for chlamydia and second for gonorrhea, while Vermont is an STD-free state. Some statistics globally. There are 15 million new STD infections in the U.S. every year. Youth from the ages 15 to 24 make over one quarter of the sexually active population, but account for half of the 15 million now new sexually transmitted diseases that occur each year.
Okay, so our first interview was with Rebecca Egan. She teaches at ESTU, and she teaches Phi Ed and wellness classes. She taught here for 11 years, and then she went to be a coach for a volleyball team, and now she's back at ESTU. One of the things that she said that I thought was important is talking to a doctor is easier than talking to your parents or to your partner, and also that we don't need your parent to come or to give you permission to go to a clinic. Our second interview was with Julie. She's a nurse manager at the First Care Pregnancy Center. She works in Minneapolis by the U of M, so many of the students come in for a checkup. They also have many STD tests, they have pregnancy tests, and they have ultrasound. The most inspiring thing she said was education is power and that we need to hear it more. She also said that pregnancy have gone down, but STD rates have gone up.
So one of the organizations we have are Planned Parenthood, which is a healthcare provider that provides STD testing and like pregnancy care, such as abortion and then the Plan B pills. So there's more than 600 centers and then also over 10 million activists.
And if you want to learn how you can control STDs, you could visit the CDC, which is an organization that specializes in this.
ASTDA is an organization dedicated to the control and study of sexually transmitted diseases. ASTDA is open to any individual interested in controlling or preventing STDs.
Some steps you could take when trying to prevent STDs would be to practice abstinence. It's basically like actually I was already explained. If you wanted to wear like protection too, like a condom or like a that will help you out with any STDs. And practice monogamy, which is trying to stay with one person during a marriage, like one bride, one husband. And you can also like educate yourself like on the risk of having sex. And if you wanted to download an app about like how you could learn about treatment of STDs, you could visit the SU.
October 20th. And for a current event, apps such as Tinder and Grindr, those are like very, so basically people can download the app, use like, and then when you match a person, you can like text them or talk to them, and then even meet up with them, which studies show that may be a cause as to why the STD rates have been so high. And then there's an app, it's in the bottom right corner, it's called Field, or it used to be called Thrinder, which is like three Tinder. So basically you can sign up as a couple or a person that's single, and then you can like choose as to which one you prefer. And then it's basically like meeting up, but more than two people. So the risk for STD is like higher because you're more exposed to those people you're meeting up with.
Okay, so three of our risk factors were peer pressure, depression, and alcohol and drug use.
Our protective factors were delaying the initiation of sex and being vaccinated. So delaying the initiation of sex can prevent STDs because the earlier you start having sex, the more at risk and expose you to having STDs. So obviously abstinence is the only way to prevent STDs for sure, but like delaying initiation also, it not only prevents STDs, but it helps like prevent unplanned pregnancy, etc. And then being vaccinated, so several STDs have vaccinations such as HPV, which is a very common one actually. And it's also very severe because it can lead to death. And so you can get the HPV shots once you turn 9 years old. And then you can get it all the way until your early 20s.
Like a solution for peer pressure would be to just try saying no. I mean, like, if you're in a person to like see that you say no and realize that you don't want to have sex with them.
Okay, so depression can also lead to STDs. Some way we can solve that is going to therapy and look or seeing a therapist, because depression, when you're depressed, sometimes it leads to having sex.
Some risk factors is alcohol and drug use. Alcohol lowers inhibitions, which means that both men and women are most likely to engage in sexual behaviors. Heavy drinkers are also more likely to have multiple partners, increasing the risk for the transmission of an STD. For example, young adults who use alcohol are 7 times more likely to have unprotected sex, according to the McKinley Health Center at the University of Illinois. Finally, alcohol can also impair any individual's immune system, making it harder to fight off an STD, which is a risk to anyone involved. So a solution would be rehab and education. It helps with those with alcohol and drug problems to help them overcome their addictions, which would help in the long run. So they are basically like involved in STD transmission and stuff. So if you just stay away from alcohol, you're most likely not to have more STD.
And if we wanted to like, keep our kids when they grow up from having sex when they like get of age, like 18 years old, 16 years old, 14 years old, then we could just have them start like wellness classes earlier, like just, we can have them start at like grades from 2 to 4. Really early, so they all know about this.
A protective factor is being vaccinated. STDs are usually effectively treated through antibiotics, although many patients do not know that they are effective and can spread they can spread disease to other partners. Vaccines for certain viral STDs are in use and many are being developed. And so a solution would be school requirements. The lack of education about STDs is a primary factor researchers focus on when trying to find a solution to reduce the rates of sexually transmitted new diseases. Adolescents under the age of 18 are the type of patients who are least informed about STDs, yet this lack of education does not stop them from having sex. Sex education is both a controversial and most certainly not taught enough in schools. Some people believe there should be abstinence approach where students are taught sex should wait until marriage. Many STDs have permanent consequences, so I think the best solution would have teens require more hours of wellness classes, or specifically just relating to the dangers of STDs and how they spread.
Okay. This is our surveys.
Okay, so one of the questions we had on our surveys was, have you been tested? And amongst those students, only 20.7% of the females said yes, and only 10.2% of the males said yes. And then we also asked if they had sexual intercourse. All of the freshmen yes said no, which is pretty good. I mean, they're pretty young, that's 14, 15 years old. And then as the age group got older, more students started saying yes than no. And compared to the Minnesota student survey, only 29.1% said that they've had sexual intercourse. And then using protection, this doesn't apply to freshmen, which is why they're not there. So most of the students said they did. And all age groups, except for juniors, it was like 50-50. And then in the Minnesota student survey,